infant holy, infant holy, for his bed a cattle stall. Oxen lowing, little knowing, Christ the babe is Lord of all. Swift are winging, angels singing, Noel's ringing, tidings bringing, Christ the babe is Lord of all. Christ the babe is Lord of all. Flocks were sleeping, shepherds keeping vigil till the morning dew. Saw the glory, heard the story, tidings of the gospel true. Thus rejoicing, free from sorrow, praises voicing, greet the morrow. Christ the babe is born for you. Christ the babe is born for you.
Thank you. Welcome to Christmas Eve worship with Wittenberg Lutheran Church. If you haven't already, I invite you to go to wittenbergleesville.org and download a bulletin so that you can fully participate in today's worship service. We join together in our call to worship. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. We gather together in the great light of the God who comes as a child. Let us worship and give thanks to Emmanuel, God with us. Holy Spirit be with you all. And also with you.
Thank you.
us pray. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Our first lesson is from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken, as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne and dominion of David, to establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Second lesson is from Titus chapter 2, verses 11 to 14. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. It is Jesus Christ who gave himself to redeem us from all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. Gospel according to St. Luke, the second chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now into Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about the child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, so this is it, huh? Christmas Eve feels a little anticlimactic this year. And I say that as someone who has been working hard to make it as festive as possible. We have decked the halls and decorated the tree. We've ordered flowers and lit candles. We are setting the scene, and I know that we are worshiping together, even though we're apart. And I know it's not the same. It's fine, mostly. There are things that we're missing, and there are things we've added in this year. Maybe we decorated early, or we made some of our favorite recipes even ahead of Christmas Day. I know some people sent out extra Christmas cards this year because they're feeling extra love for family and friends. Others are scheduling online, Zoom or FaceTime, or in the front yard kinds of meetings to keep connected with people that they love. I can't help but wonder what Mary and Joseph were thinking when they arrived in Bethlehem for the census, with her pregnant, ready to burst. Well, so this is it, huh? They couldn't find a hotel room, or a spare bedroom with some third cousins, or a midwife, for that matter, as far as we can tell. They started making a place for the night in the coziest stall in a stable. Mary was probably coaching Joseph about childbirth, telling him what she knew from being there for her cousin Elizabeth when John was born. I wonder if they were thinking that the angel left this part out of the message. Could this really be where the Messiah was going to be born? Come to think of it, that's sort of the reaction people had to Jesus, finding out that this man from Nazareth, who looks like their cousin, is in fact the Messiah, the Christ, God. That's it? God's chosen one? The one who is going to save us all, the Redeemer of the universe and King of creation, is that guy? But that's how it is. God isn't impressed the way that people are. God chose shepherds to be the first to know that the Messiah had been born. The welcome wagon for this most important baby was the stinky farm boys from out on the hills. I bet they even brought a lamb or two with them. It was a stable anyway. That's who the angels came to, not the mayor of Bethlehem or the king of Judea. They came to field laborers and let them know the good news. No one else. That was it. God didn't choose for his son to be born into royalty, but to peasants, to people who make ends meet with hard work and hard hands. There wasn't a soft bed or any bed for the newborn king. There was a feed trough, and that was it. And there weren't baby showers or midwives or onesies or disposable diapers. There was Mary and Joseph and some cloth and some animals. And that was it. And you know, it was enough. The baby got born, as babies do. The Son of God became flesh, became one of us, without fanfare or fuss. There wasn't a royal proclamation or a parade. The stable, the love of parents, it was enough. Jesus of Nazareth, fully God and fully human, didn't look like much, the Bible tells us. The prophet Isaiah says that he had no beauty or majesty that we should look at him. People certainly didn't take notice of or write down what he looked like. Not everyone who saw him believed that he was the Messiah, even when he said so, or preached the word, or healed the sick, and forgave the sinners, and calmed the waves. And he was enough. He wasn't enough because he was Mary and Joseph's son, good as they were. Jesus wasn't enough because he had superpowers of his own. Jesus was enough because he is one with God the Father and God the Spirit. Jesus was enough because the fullness of God was there. The stable was enough because it held the Lord God. The shepherds were enough because God sent them. Jesus was and is enough to change this world. Jesus was and is enough to save us from our sins and to redeem every sorrow and every struggle in this life. Jesus was enough then. Jesus is enough now. There may be a time or two during this holiday season where you wonder if this is it. The gathering may feel small, or the celebration may seem a little muted. It's likely to feel like less than usual this year. The first Christmas was probably a little underwhelming too, but it was enough. God was born, and the whole world was on its way to being saved. This Christmas, because of that Christmas, God is with us. God is with you right now, where you are. God celebrates with us. God struggles with us. God is always with us. And through God's grace, it is enough. Alleluia. Amen. Let us confess our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Joining our voices with the song of the angels, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. The shepherds sing, Jesus Christ is born. Let your church throughout the world proclaim this good news over the hills and everywhere. Unite the voices of all your faithful people in songs of praise and rejoicing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heaven and nature sing, joy to the world. Be with us when the cares and griefs of this world start to overcome the joy that we have in you. Make us know that you are Emmanuel, God with us in every moment of this season. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The angels sing, peace on earth. Come quickly to still the strife of this world. Hush the noise of war and violence in places of unrest. Inspire leaders of nations to seek lasting peace and sustainable provision for all in their care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Mary sings melodies of comfort to her newborn child. Bring rest and reassurance to those facing struggles this night. Shelter travelers and those without homes. Console those who lie awake due to pain or anxiety. Heal those who are sick or hurting. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Love sings through the sound of a new baby's cry. Bless new parents and expectant parents. Comfort those who long for children, especially those running out of hope or options. Surround families of every shape and size with your love and care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The heavenly chorus sings, glory to God in the highest. We give you thanks for all the saints who have proclaimed your glory in word and deed. Let us join them this night in joyful praise around your eternal throne. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of mercy, come quickly to us with grace upon grace as we lift these and all our prayers to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deep in the stillness of one night, our God gave us the precious gift of the Christ child, Jesus, his own son, born in human flesh, to save this world from sin and from death and from the devil. One of the ways that we show our worship of God is through our offering, giving back to God from what God has given to us. We do this through our time and our talents, through the ways that we care for others, and through our treasures. If you're feeling called to donate to God's mission tonight through Wittenberg Lutheran Church, you can give online at wittenberglesville.org, or you can give through the mail at P.O. Box 3447 in Leesville, South Carolina. Let us pray in blessing over these offerings that we give to God out of what God has given to us. Merciful Father, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Merry Christmas.